To be able to interact with our user, we'll work with the ask and answer blocks. Sometimes I want to get information from the user. The user's whoever's playing my game or working with my program. On the sensing tab, there's this block. Ask, what is your name, and wait. Here I can type in anything. When I double click on this block, the user will be able to type in their name. Watch what happens. So here I can type, my name is Colleen. Okay, but where does that go? After I ask that question, it sets this variable, answer, to whatever I typed in. If you see here, answer right now is Colleen. If I do it again and type Colleen Lewis, then this time answer will be Colleen Lewis. So when I run this block, whatever someone types in will be the new value of answer. Watch what I can do with that. I can say if, and I want to see if answer is equal to Colleen. So I'll go to operators, get an equals, I can go back to sensing to get answer, and I can say if answer is equal to Colleen, and I'll say hello Colleen. Okay, let's try it. If I double click on this, it'll ask me for my name, and it won't do any of the blocks after that ask until I type something in. If I type in that my name is Colleen, then the cat says, hello, Colleen, just like I told it to. If I run this script again and type in something else, like say I type in Colleen Lewis, then it doesn't say anything. Because there, answer, just like we can see here, answer is not equal to Colleen, so it didn't say, hello, Colleen. What's cool about ask is it sets the variable answer for us. So no matter what the person types in, the variable answer will have that as its value.